One issue, two points of view. Agora.
This edition of Agora is a review of 2009 with two guests. Ezio Mauro is managing editor of Italy's La Repubblica newspaper. Dennis McShane is a member of Parliament at Westminster and formerly Tony Blair's European Affairs Minister. They met up in December at the third European Book Prize at the European Parliament and agreed to look at Europe's year in terms of its democracy and its culture.
There were two anniversaries this year, 89 of course, and the fall of the Berlin Wall and the end of communism. But it was also NATO's 60th birthday. NATO was set up in 1949, and after the isolationism following the First World War, the Americans decided to stay in Europe. But maybe we should worry less about celebrating the past than planning for the future.
Yes, that's one of the differences between a European and an American mindset and culture, the problems of the what next and the past. However, I think the wall's importance was validated by the size of the celebrations. It was a real fracture in our history, and not only our geography. The problem now, in my opinion, is Europe must be sure of its identity. And when I say that, I identify Europe with democracy, the rule of law, and democratic institutions.
That's fully accepted, but can't we see other divisions and other walls coming? Intolerance is also a wall, so is xenophobia. We've seen the Swiss referendum results on minarets, and we've seen ferocious ideological Islamic opposition to democratic values, women's rights, gay rights, etc. We can see resistance to foreigners in every EU member state. In Britain, Poles and Slovaks can be victims of racism. It's not just about skin colour. How do we fight that? How do we get a more tolerant, less xenophobic Europe?
That's the problem of the moment. You know we have problems with intolerance in Italy right now. There's the debate over immigrants, and the big debate over the crucifix. The immigrant issue rapidly became an ideological issue. Not just a question of security, and not even a political one. It became more complicated and dangerous. It's a risk for democracy and a risk for the whole of Europe. It could open the way for a new type of populism, as in complicated times, voters can be tempted by simple remedies.
Periodo di complessità e peut-être une tentation de simplification.
Yes, I was very struck by what the European Conservatives Edward Macmillan Scott said about fascism light. In fact, this European Parliament has between 100 and 120 elected members following a low election turnout who represent populist, sometimes overtly racist, nationalist, and even anti-Semitic forces. It's unthinkable to imagine any return of anti-Semitic discourse in European politics. But if the left is taking the climate change road to become an ecological left, the right could become more populist and play identity politics.
La droite peut-être marche dans les directions du populisme et cette politique identitaire.
But let's get back to the wall celebrations. I agree with you that Europe has rediscovered itself in some way.
Je partage votre opinion que l'Europe s'est retrouvé son identité dans une certaine façon, surtout...
I was in Prague recently, and in Warsaw. But 30, 40 years ago, visiting these Eastern European capitals was a sad affair. The crisis was all too real. Today, they dazzle. They've rediscovered their historical heritage. How do we promote these ideals to our neighbours, into Africa and the Middle East? How do we promote democracy and freedom of expression in China, for example?
I think the fact that we know we are the lands of democracy, the rule of law and democratic institutions should guide us in our approach towards other countries. But there's a problem when we speak about democracy. The economic crisis and recession, strains on the family and globalization are all serious challenges for individuals and small communities. All of this can erode democracy and the value of using it at all.
De valeur d'utilisation de la démocratie.
Mais ça vient aussi de la culture. C'est vrai.
It's also a cultural question. I think it's a real problem. We now have many cultures in Europe. We have magnificent films, writers, plays, but Europe's almost becoming more national. Do we really today have great writers or historians building a sort of universal European philosophy? I'm just asking the question. I have my doubts. I don't think that today in any member state anyone can say, yes, I must read that. It'll give me ideas to help me realize myself and have a share in Europe's culture, rather than find a work that captures an essential English or Polish or German, Italian or French perspective.
There's a problem of a European dimension of leadership and the importance of institutions. I think that Europe is the only way for our corner of the world, our people, our nations, to measure up and play a part in the great global decisions of the moment.
De compter dans les décisions du monde dans ce moment.
We'll see in 2010. If the Lisbon Treaty and its new champions, Mr. Barroso, Mr. Van Rompuy and Baroness Ashton, if they stay in place for the next 5 years, and we have a better Europe at the end of it in 2014, the one we wish for, we'll see. I'm convinced it's important to build the idea of a European culture. So I'm very happy we've awarded this European Book Prize for the third year. This prize is a small start, but with time I hope it'll become one of our great literature and essay prizes.